The revelation was made by Ramadan Gowi, the Secretary to the Treasury, while updating journalists on the quarter three expenditure releases for 2023-2024 at the ministry head offices, where journalists asked him to explain the government's preparedness to hold the local council elections. Gowi noted that these polls will be done in future since the government has no money.
There's no money for LOC1 elections now. They will be done in the future. I think the Minister of Local Government informed you. Parliament has never appropriated money for this purpose.
However, he was reminded by journalists that in October 2023, the Minister of Finance, Planning and Economic Development announced that 58 billion shillings had been released to the Electoral Commission to organize elections of LC1s and LC2s plus women council elections.
Let's first count all Ugandans to know actually how many Ugandans are non-LC. So that they can carry out also the election. So census money was first than now bringing people from another LOC to line up in the back of another.
During the briefing, Gowi revealed that the government had released funding amounting to 4.974 trillion shillings, excluding debt for the third quarter of the financial year 2023-2024. Of the amount released, 1.91 trillion shillings is for payment of wages.
I wish to inform all stakeholders that this Ministry of Finance, Planning and Economic Development has received the audit report on the wage payroll, which was done by the Auditor General of Government on our request as a ministry. And going forward, this report shall be our basis of providing funds for wage.
20 billion shillings has been provided to Kampala Capital City Authority to fix potholes and payment of compensation for land for the African Development Bank projects. The Secretary to the Treasury.
We are committed as government to addressing them. Now you are saying more money is being spent on these potholes. The potholes also were many. And we are fixing them. We want Kampala to revamp all of this infrastructure. We are not going to be, this is just a stopgap measure. I've told you most of these roads, I've told you again and again, are going to be redone.
The Secretary to the Treasury also responded to the latest threats by teachers and intern medical doctors who are threatening an industrial strike if the issues surrounding salary enhancement aren't addressed. Gowi was spot on that there are no funds to address such concerns.
Teachers who want salary enhancement, please tell them there is no salary enhancement because there is no money for such things at this point in time.
Gowi has also revealed plans to carry out an investigation on the misuse of money meant for coffee value chain after confirming that the government appropriated $10 million to a coffee consortium through the Ministry of Science, Technology and Innovations.
When I hear the fights, I'm also hearing them. We shall find out exactly what these fights are about. What? Could it be failure to share in a way they were supposed to share it, to do this work? The results, me, I told you, my accountability is with the results.
In the statement provided by the Minister of Finance on the quarterly releases, 249.578 billion shillings has been released to local government's grants, including capitation grants of 136.5 billion shillings to ensure timely opening of the first school term, while 90.211 billion shillings has been provided to national medical stores to meet the obligations for the purchase of essential medicines, and another 57.955 billion shillings has been availed to the referral hospitals, cancer, and the Heart Institute. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.